My name is Felix Mahfoud. I'm a cardiologist working here at the Saarland University Hospital in Hamburg, Saar, Germany. Well, the Global SYMPLICITY Registry is the largest and longest follow-up population of real-world patients with uncontrolled hypertension treated with radiofrequency renal denervation. And the objective of the registry are to assess the long-term safety and effectiveness of the SYMPLICITY renal denervation system. With renal denervation, we very often see different clinical benefits that may be measured by multiple variables, such as office and or ambulatory blood pressure reductions, but often also we document a change in antihypertensive medication burden. The win ratio analysis enables evaluation of clinical benefits based on multiple variables and a hierarchical composite endpoint. And that was the purpose of the study. We used the Global SYMPLICITY Registry, which is the largest and longest follow-up population of real-world patients with uncontrolled hypertension. And in this cohort, we assessed using a win ratio methodology the impact of renal denervation on various endpoints in patients who were elderly, in patients with diabetes, and in patients with chronic kidney disease. Because very often after renal denervation, the outcomes, the changes are quite variable. One patient may show a reduction in office blood pressure. Another patient may show no change in blood pressure, but a decrease in ambulatory blood pressure. And a third patient may show no change in blood pressure, no reduction in ambulatory blood pressure, but decreases antihypertensive medication burden throughout follow-up. All of these are important endpoints. And the win ratio analysis enables to assess these outcomes using a hierarchical analysis. First, we documented significant office and 24-hour ambulatory blood pressure reductions that sustained throughout 3 years in the Global SYMPLICITY Registry in more than 2,800 patients. We also documented, using the win ratio analysis, ranking office 24-hour blood pressure reductions and medication changes, additional insights into the benefits of renal denervation in high-risk cohorts. And these cohorts suffered from diabetes or chronic kidney disease or were elderly individuals, indeed above 65 years of age. And what we found were that patients were equally likely to experience a reduction in office, ambulatory, and/or medication burden between these high-risk subgroups. And importantly, a new study, the GSR Define, will include patients very shortly and will extend our knowledge about renal denervation when used in real-world experience. The results from the win ratio analysis demonstrate comparable probability of responding to renal denervation therapy regardless of age, chronic kidney disease, or diabetes status, indicating similar efficacy based on ambulatory, office blood pressure, and/or medication burden between these high-risk patient cohorts. The Global SYMPLICITY Registry will now be followed and extended by the new GSR Define study that will expand our knowledge on renal denervation when used in clinical practice in over 5,000 real-world patients treated with radiofrequency catheter-based renal denervation.